إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن خير الكلام كلام الله تعالى، وإن خير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وإن كل محدثة بدعة، وإن كل بدعة ضلالة، وإن كل ضلالة في النار، أعاذنا الله منها وإياكم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, how lucky we are to reach Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the opportunity to go through it, fasting its days, standing during its nights, and spending from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that every single deed you do is yours. كل عمل ابن آدم له إلا الصيام. Except fasting, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He is the one who rewards for it. And here we are at the month. If we get the sincerity to stand its night, من قامه إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. If you do it out of belief in what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained upon you, and looking for the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. Allahumma ameen. A believer, when it comes to the month of the Ramadan, should have some kind of longing, waiting. Ibn al-Qayyim spoke about love and put a shawq as one degree, longing towards something. And among the best, الشوق إلى الله تعالى, longing for God سبحانه وتعالى. And Ramadan is one of those steps that المشتاقون, those who have that deep love with longing to stand in front of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, fast its days and pray its nights. This is the opportunity. This is the opportunity for those who are looking toward Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hadith said, if a worshipper gets closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shibr, إِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِ شِبْرًا. والشبر is the space or the distance between the tip of your thumb and the tip of your little finger when you spread your hand. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get closer to you, dhira', and a dhira' is the from the elbow to the tip of your hand, double the space roughly. وَإِذَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ ذِرَاعًا تَقَرَّبْتُ إِلَيْهِ بَاعًا يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلْ. If the worshipper got closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one arm length, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will get closer to him one ba', which is the distance between the tips of your finger when you spread your hand like this. It's about four times. And if you come towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala walking, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get closer to you running. It's an exponential formula. You get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you head in that direction, and you're gonna meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the distance that you put for yourself, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is moving towards you faster than you can think. This is ash-shawqu ila Allah ta'ala in the month of Ramadan, waiting for the days to fast, waiting for the minutes to read the Quran, waiting for the opportunity to stand up at the night. Ibn al-Qayyim mentioned a nice explanation about the verse that our dear Imam spoke a little bit about before the khutbah, about death. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for those who have longing for Him, chose for Him, for them, a verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified for them. مَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ أَجَلَ اللَّهِ لَآتِ. Whoever has the longing to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ajal is right there. When it comes to death, we're all afraid. We're not ready. We all agree to that. But can we train ourselves to wait for that moment to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can we prepare ourselves, get off our shoulders the loads of this life and get ready? Like the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended, إِذَا أَصْبَحْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الْمَسَاءِ وَإِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَظِرِ الصَّبَاحِ. If you walk in the morning, don't wait that much for the evening. And if the evening came upon you, don't wait that much for the morning. The meaning of which, do what you have to do in that time and do not procrastinate. The duties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote upon us, like the salah, was timed. Kitaban mawquta. And the month of Ramadan provide us with the yearly cleansing opportunity to dust off what has been on our shoulder for a year. It's an opportunity to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an opportunity to get through this month of accountability, Shahrul Muhasaba. It's the month that the believer will hold himself accountable. And I'm not talking about the financial one, which should happen. And many of the good people who passed before us, as-salihun, they used to wait for the month of Ramadan to get their zakat out. But I'm talking about the accountability of the soul. In one definition of al-muhasaba, among many that I would like to share with you today, قالوا عنها هي فحص الطاعة ظاهرا وباطنا. To inspect your obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and following His orders inside out. وَأَوَّلًا وَآخِرًا, from the beginning to the end. بَحْثًا عَنِ الثَّمَرَةِ لِيَعْرِفَ مَأْتَاهَا, looking for the fruit to know how it came about. فَيَحْفَظُهُ وَقَدَرَهَا فَيُنَمِّيهُ. So you could protect the fruit of your worship and you understand the weight of which and try to increase on it. وَوُصُولًا لِلنَّحْسِ سَابِقًا. So you understand the deficiencies of the past. لِيَتَدَارَكَهُ لَاحِقًا. So that you can avoid it in the future. That's accountability. Look into our prayers. As scholars said, among the signs for acceptance is to continue what you're doing. If we were praying Taraweeh last Ramadan and we did not stand up during the night since then until now, we have an opportunity to ask ourselves now and renew our intention. As one scholar was asked, I prepare the water I need to make my wudu with. I prepare myself, I get everything ready, I don't wake up at night. And he told him, your sins, your mistakes chained you. It's an honor to stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we disobey him during the daytime, why would he give us that opportunity to stand at the night? But in the month of Ramadan, we all get that opportunity. It's a renewal, open window to renew yourself, your prayers, your fasting, your standing, make up your intention, get to renew yourself, cleanse yourself, be ready to move on forward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get us all among those who get through this month of Ramadan and get out forgiven. Allahumma ameen. Jibreel alayhi salam came to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a hadith that was relayed to us that should really scare us. Jibreel said to the Messenger, and he told him, say ameen after me. من أدرك شهر رمضان فلم يغفر له فدخل النار فأبعده الله. قل آمين. And the Messenger said آمين. He told them, whoever reached Ramadan and does not get the opportunity, does not make use of the opportunity to get forgiven, and he get into the hellfire and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cast him away, let it be that way. Say آمين. And the Messenger said آمين. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that none of us, none of our children, none of our grandchildren will be out of the forgiveness of Ramadan. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we all go through it, earn the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day, during the time, and throughout all this month. Allahumma ameen. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum fa ya fawza al-mustaghfirin. Astaghfirullah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. Brothers and sisters in Islam, as we come through the masjid, and I'm one of those who moved to South Florida about 7 years ago, and I came to this masjid on and off. And I recall coming to this community when it was in the previous compound. And I learned from my mentors that every time I come to a place that people put their effort in, to say, oh Allah, thank to you and to the people who put this together. Every square inch of a carpet that you are praying on came through effort of people who put time, sweat, and money to put it together. And our community is growing. And I'm coming to you today with humbleness to represent ICNA Relief. An opportunity for us all, not only to build a masjid as we should, and we did, but to build a community at large. Whether we are talking about serving 1.8 million people in the US last year in 2020 with food baskets and other services, to the shelter places that some dear sisters need to find a place for one night or more. These are things that history will write for Muslims altogether. Years from now, it will not be said X or Y or Z did this, but it will be said that the Muslim community in South Florida did that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings us the opportunities for us to make use of. As the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ فِي الدَّهْرِ نَفَحَاتٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout time has certain blasts, breathing, opportunities. Make use of it. It comes across even if you did not work hard for it. And in the hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, maybe one of you will make use of that opportunity, فَلَا يَشْقَى بَعْدَهَا أَبَدًا. You make use of one of those opportunities that come across, and you will not be miserable after that period. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that these are opportunities that you will make use of. Today after the prayer, I'm going to beg you for a few minutes to raise funds for so many projects that you are aware of. But less than a mile from here, ICNA Relief had already secured a place where they will store food and an office. And they are working on many other projects here in Florida and elsewhere. It's some kind of a tax that we need to pay for our existence. Non-Muslims don't happen to cross by as usual. But when we have someone like Ikna Relief, it's an arm that is reaching in the community, calling for you, Ya Baghi Al-Khayri Aqbil. If you're looking for the opportunities to serve Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you just have to connect. Whether you connect through volunteering or through your money, do it. يقول صلى الله عليه وسلم سبق درهم 100,000. $1 ran with rewards ahead with that person, more than 100,000. They asked him, how is that, O Messenger of Allah? He said, this person came to $2 of his, split them in half. And the other one, Ja'ila Aradi Mali, he came to abundance of money and spent 100,000. It's all between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not about a dollar or two. It's about longing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ash-shawqu ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aqbil ala Allah mushtaqan bi siyamik. Wa aqbil ala Allah mushtaqan bi qiyamik. Wa aqbil ala Allah mushtaqan bi infaqik. Show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you long for Him by fasting, by standing, and by spending. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote us all among those who would be written among al-mushtaqeen today. Allahumma ameen, ameen, ya rabbal ameen, inni da'in fa'aminu. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana, wa fil akhirati hasana, wa qina adhab an-nar. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana, wa hab lana min ladunka rahmatan innaka antal wahhab. اللهم أنت الرحمن الرحيم، أنت الملك القدوس، أنت السلام، أنت المؤمن، أنت المهيمن، أنت العزيز، أنت الجبار، أنت المتكبر، سبحانك عما يشركون. اللهم إنا نسألك بكل اسم هو لك، سميت به نفسك، وأنزلته في كتابك، أو علمته أحدا من خلقك، أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك، أن تجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا وقلوب أولادنا يا أرحم الراحمين، ونورا في صدورنا وصدور أولادنا يا رب العالمين، ومفرجا لهمومنا وهموم أولادنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم علمنا وعلم أولادنا ما ينفعنا من القرآن الكريم، اللهم علمنا تلاوته على النحو الذي يرضيك عنا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا في هذا الشهر الكريم، وأعنا على صيامه وقيامه والإنفاق فيه يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اهدنا واهدي بنا، واجعلنا هادين مهديين غير ضالين ولا مضلين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يغفر لكم ذنوبكم.